At Cleveland-Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry, over 70 individual animals have been found. So normally when we find dinosaurs in groups together, they're herbivorous dinosaurs. So that's really strange that almost everything we found here are carnivorous dinosaurs. In addition to Allosaurus fragilis, we have Ceratosaurus, we have Marchosaurus, Stokesosaurus, so a lot of the carnivorous dinosaurs. And then the herbivorous dinosaurs we have are Barosaurus, Camptosaurus, Stegosaurus, but they're definitely the minority. And we are the repository for them. And so we have them in our collection space here. My name is Carrie Levin-Bouzian, and I'm the Paleontology Collections Manager here at the Natural History Museum of Utah. And we're in the Cleveland Lloyd aisles because everything in both of these cabinets, all the way down, both of these rows are from Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry.
Another gap, and then another small tooth will grow up. Eventually, it'll be fully erupted.
Over 12,000 bones have been found at Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry, and we have the majority of the bones found in that site.
As a land management agency, our responsibility is not only to the fossils and the natural history on the ground, but what happens to these objects after they're collected by museums. And so we work closely with many natural history museums to ensure that these fossils are available for future generations.
So what's really awesome about this collection is that we are on the University of Utah campus. And so we have students that research the fossils here. We have professors having field trips here that they can see the fossils. We actually have student interns that come and work with me in collections, but we are a research institution. And so we have people, researchers come from all over the world, come and study our fossils here.
So what type of research has been done with these fossils from Cleveland Lloyd here?
Yeah, so it's really neat. These have actually been histologically analyzed. So what that means is someone has taken this bone, cut it in half, and made that section into a thin section to look at under a microscope, kind of like what we have here. And you can tell a lot of information about the animal by cutting it up. You can tell how old it was when it died, how old it was when it reached sexual maturity, if it was warm-blooded or cold-blooded.
This is some of the follow-up work that's done by researchers here at the museum or researchers that come and visit the collections to use these specimens.
Yes, and since we have the slide collection, we can actually loan these out too to people all over the world.
So this specimen may get used over and over again by many researchers. It's not a one-time deal. And so who knows, someone 50 years from now may have a new question and this slide may provide the information to answer that question.
Absolutely. So I have a lot of favorite specimens from Cleveland Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry. My favorite, I think, is the Allosaurus leg bone that actually has amethyst inside of it. So that permineralization process is truly spectacular. So each fossil actually has a number on it, or in this case, two numbers on it. And that number actually gets linked in the database to all the supplemental material that we have. The preparation sheets, the field notes, the field photos, everything gets linked to that number. And we keep track of that in the database. And so this way we can ensure that it was collected legally and tie it back to the appropriate land agency it was found on.
Blood vessel. So basically you had nerves and blood vessels coming in, and that's probably.
So only about 1% of the specimens that are in a museum ever goes on display. And it actually takes a long time of the fossil's journey from when you excavate it in the ground to being on display in our museum. So sometimes it takes years to even excavate it out of the ground. And then we have to bring it back to our prep lab, open it up, clean it up, glue it back together, and then it either goes on display or it comes up here in collections to be protected in this environment. Museum displays like this are really important because they bring fossils that have been found on public land to the museum and showcase them in the museum. Anybody can come here to see it. And what it's doing is it's showcasing what might have happened at Cleveland-Lloyd Dinosaur Quarry. And so I have a barosaurus, the sauropod, the long neck, long tail guy behind me, and it's being attacked by a herd of Allosaurus fragilis, which is Utah state fossil. And we have both sub-adults, there's even a sub-adult on the back of the barosaurus, and hopefully encourage people to ask questions, what might have happened, and maybe to get themselves down to Cleveland-Lloyd, because it's one of the only dinosaur digs that you can actually visit and see people digging up the dinosaur bones.
It's always really cool because when we're working in the buildings and we're excavating or mapping or anything else, I think it's really awesome that we can kind of converse with the visitors as they're coming in. We can answer those questions that they have, because right now it's like you come in and there's just bones everywhere. And so it's like, hey, what am I looking at? And then we can sit there and talk with them about what they're actually looking at and how potentially it got there.